Good evening, everybody. We want to welcome you all to this week's edition of Southern Woods and Waters. Hope you're having a great Thursday evening, sitting around the house with the family and enjoying the show tonight. We've got a really special one for you again tonight. You know, there's over the years, we have deer hunted. I've deer hunted my whole life, have lots of friends that have, and over the years, you build memories, you know, as you go. Every time you go, usually you're going to come out with some kind of memory or something from that, but there's very few hunts or things that you'll ever experience that'll be something you'll remember more so than your first deer. And tonight, we're gonna get to share that, a very special first deer. And I've got in the studio with me tonight, Miss Courtney Smalley. And we're gonna be going to the woods with you tonight on your, not your first deer hunt, but your first deer.
Right.
And really looking forward to sharing that. Got my buddy Anthony in here. It's great to have you back down here this week.
Glad to be back, always glad to be here.
Courtney, just to set this up just a little bit, now you were hunting, I'm sorry about this, but you was hunting with our buddy Duck.
I was.
You were out there with Duck. No, he's a hoot. I know y'all had a good time, I guarantee you. But Duck, he's out, he's working, believe it or not. He's got to work before deer season so he can quit during deer season.
He may try to be here tonight, but he couldn't.
That's how he does it. But you went out with Duck, and so I want to back all the way up though. You've been hunting now for a few years. This isn't brand new. 3 years. So what started 3 years ago? What all of a sudden what got you into this?
So I have an 8-year-old and he saw a shooting house.
Okay.
Well, he thought it was an Army Ranger station. So we had to tell him what it was about. And we said, okay, we'll take him. Papaw took us. And then once I got in that stand, I'm like, man, I kind of like this. I want to try. So he said, all right, come back in the morning and we'll do it. And I was hooked just sitting, watching.
Just going and enjoying and being out there. And have you done anything other than deer hunt? I know you've bow fished now. I know that.
Bow fished. I have J.R. Sweat took me on a dove hunt.
That's a lot of fun.
I have been on a couple turkey hunts.
Yeah.
Couldn't draw them in close enough to us, but I've been turkey hunting.
Yeah. We might be able to do something about that this spring, Anthony.
Yeah, I know.
You know, it'd be all right to get her on film shooting her first turkey, too, you know.
And Duck's farm is covered, I'm going to tell you.
I believe he'd let her come down and do that most likely.
Yeah, I know he would.
So a couple years goes by, you've been after him, just hadn't had any luck yet. And somehow or another, you get hooked up with Duck, I guess probably through online or D3 Outdoors or something like that.
I just followed him on Facebook, and then I started getting trail camera pictures. I'm like, oh, this is Duck Madeer, and if you watch D3, you've seen his wall.
Yeah.
I mean, it's covered. They're just floor ceiling. And he says, call me. I'm like, oh, my gosh. So I'm shaking. I was like, hello? And he said, what are you doing in the morning? It didn't matter what I was doing in the morning.
I
had a feeling. I'm like, I'm getting pictures. He's calling me. He said, I had a spot come open. He said, no, I want to film you. I want to put you on a deer. He said, we're going to film this for Southern Woods and Waters. And I'm like, you are kidding me. Tears are rolling down my face at this point because I knew something was going to happen.
Yeah, absolutely.
I knew something.
And so a special friend donates a place for y'all to be able to go home.
Right. He said, I'm telling you, whatever plans you got, you better cancel them because this is a – not many people get it, he said, but I'm taking you to the big house. I'm taking you to Anthony Landreth's farm. The tears really went, okay, I'll be there.
That's great. So I guess he called you.
He did.
Said, you know, here's the deal, and y'all put it together and said, we're going to get her on a deer.
Yeah. And pretty much, I mean, you know how it is when you got good friends. Duck is one of the few. Duck's got a key to my farm, and he can go anytime he wants to.
Yeah.
Because he returns a favor for me.
Right,
he's got an awesome turkey farm.
Yeah.
And when he's down in Louisiana, he said, look, treat it like it's yours. So I treat my farm the same way with Duck.
That's how it works.
Yep.
I mean, that's how it works in the outdoor world.
That's right.
A lot of times, and a lot of people lose focus of that.
Yeah.
You do for one another, and a lot of times you'll get a lot more accomplished than you will trying to do it on your own.
And I mean, develop, which I know you know this, but you develop friendships and bonds. I mean, I don't know, it's like your friends in the outdoors. They just don't get no closer.
No,
right?
They don't. And I'm sure you've already started learning that just
in
the, you know, just the amount of time you've been around. I mean, it's like a, it's a bond that's automatically there.
That's right.
That's, you know, now you're kind of there, you're in the family now. That's it, you know, and it's a bond that's
and
formed.
And they have all treated me just like that, too.
There's some pretty good old guys you've been hanging out with, again.
They're all right.
We'll get you down here as soon as we can. That West Tennessee group, they're all right. You know, but like I say, I know y'all had a good time. The few times I've gotten to be with Duck, I spent a few days with him in camp, as a matter of fact, at the Hope Outdoors hunt this past year. And he's just always so happy and he's just ready to go. Duck's just one of those people that he'll get you fired up and ready to go. I'm sure you were ready to get in a stand. Man, he's got some pictures this year. Some pretty good ones too. So.
Yes, he's got. Matter of fact, I was at his farm yesterday. He's got all these cell cameras just like sitting right there, you know. But then he's probably got, I think, 20 or 21 still run the SD cards.
Yeah.
So I went over to Haywood County yesterday, and I checked all of them for him. He wanted me to ride down corn lanes because in front of his deer house. Of course, every time I'd ride one down, he'd say, now crawl up in the house and take a picture and send it to me. So I'd have to go, I'd have to crawl up in the deer house and take a picture and send it to him. He'd say, okay, go to that one on the left, knock down one more lane all the way down through there. So it took me an hour doing that. Should have took 15 minutes. But
you got it right.
Yeah, you know how matter
You got it right. That's how it is, man. And, you know, I think, too, the way that this all worked out, I also want to talk about when this was. This was last year in December.
Mm-hmm.
So before we get calls about rifle hunting and
right.
all that,
yeah.
this was last year in December when all this happened. And we had a very, very blessed deer season here last year at Southern Woods and Waters, and actually have a whole slew of hunts from this past season that we're going to be sharing throughout the next little while, because there's a lot of great hunts, but we were just so blessed. We were getting on up into March this past year, and it was like, guys, we got to move on to some crappie and turkey and things like that. We try to kind of roll with the season. So this is one of those hunts that we're going back and pulling out from this past year and sharing it now. And we're going to be sharing this in segment two, just so you guys know. So we're just kind of building this up. We're not forgetting about running the video. This is coming up here in just the next segment. Tell me this. What kind of plans do you have for this year? I mean, are you ready to get back in the woods this year and get after them again now?
I've already been in. I've taken up archery so I can get out there sooner than rifle season.
Yeah, I've seen you've been shooting your bow quite a bit. Now, Tucker, you mentioned too real fast that you had an 8-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he's gotten into shooting with you.
He has. He's the one that wanted to start learning it originally.
Yeah.
I thought, well, I can't coach him through this if I don't know what I'm doing.
Right, yeah.
So I walked into the archery shop all proud, like I knew what I was doing. I couldn't pull 20 pounds by myself.
Well, you got set up. You're doing it now, and you're doing it well.
I told the owner of the shop, Phil Long, with Shelby Forest Archery, I said, I want to be in the woods this season. I'll put in the effort if you teach me how.
Yeah.
And so I've been twice a week religiously going.
I was
going
to say, from just following you and the videos and pictures and things you put on Facebook, They're going to be in trouble if they come in bow range.
She's got four Robin Hoods already. Got two as long as I ever shot, you know.
Yeah, you flat out been doing some shooting, so I'm looking forward to seeing how your archery season goes, too. But, guys, let's go over right now and do this week's wild game forecast. This week's Wild Game Forecast has been sponsored by our friends over at Wilson Bank and Trust. You can stop in and see them at one of 28 Middle Tennessee locations. They've been taking care of all your banking and financial needs now for over 30 years. Be sure to stop in and tell them thank you for all they do for us here at the show.
I just love
him. All right, guys, welcome back. Your forecast, I think, is looking pretty good. Now, I got a picture literally just a minute ago in the parking lot of a nice buck up and moving around. And what's going on, guys, is this front's pushing in here.
Yep.
Tomorrow, there's a major front that's moving through and going to push through here. And tomorrow night, we're going to have some rain and some high winds. But following in behind that, cold front. Now, what I think it's going to turn the fishing on pretty good, too, for those of you that want to head to the lake. These fishing get really good over the next few weeks. The water temperatures are getting down. Everything's getting right. But your deer hunting, for you deer hunters this weekend, I personally think Sunday and Sunday afternoon are going to be very, very prime.
Me too.
But starting Saturday afternoon on the tail end of this, be a great time to get in the stand. So your forecast is looking pretty good, whether you want to be in the woods or on the water this weekend. Guys, also remember to follow us on Facebook. Keep up with us there. We've always got a giveaway or something going on for you. And also at SWWTV.com, you can check out all of our past episodes and links to all of our great sponsors. We'll be back here in just a minute with this week's Picture of the Week and some great hunting video for you, some more Southern Woods and Waters.